Thank you. The way the world knows. We want you to understand. God hasn't called us to grieve, but to time like this. So we're in a thanksgiving service. Yes, grief has its own, but celebrating the life of our mother. Mother Lee is what we are here to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God, worship. And then we'll hand over to our mother. Thank you, Father. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. For I rise again. Ain't no corner can keep me.
Thank you.
Watching grandma's funeral. grandma's.
Grandma's night?
No, different grandma. This fucking woman sat there in this fucking
to your God. We adore you. We say thank you, Rabbi. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Father. Sweet lover of our soul. These are the mercies we pray and we say. Amen. Bless the name of Jesus.
Let's be speaking from Job 19:23-27. Oh, that my words may be recorded. Oh, that they could be inscribed in my mind. Carved with an iron chisel and filled with lead, engraved forever in bronze. But as for me, I know that my redeemer lives, and he will stand upon the earth and dust. After my body was decayed, yet in my body I was 27. I will see him for myself. Yes, I will see him in my own eyes, and I am overwhelmed.
The Lord has spoken, let the church say, amen. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Just give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Show hallelujah. That's the highest praise for my life. Hallelujah.
verse 23. And this will be read by Doreen Grove, sister of the deceived. Bless the Lord, verse 22, verse 22. Praise the Lord. I'm still reading the word of God, and I'm always going to ask the congregation to stand with us as we read the word of God. Bless the name of Jesus.
For to me, living is living in Christ, and dying is even more better. But if I live, I can do more fruitful work for Christ. So I really don't know which is better. I'm torn between two desires. I long to go to be with Christ, which would be far better for me.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. We should have a good time.
Can't take away our memories either.
In the end, life is stronger than death. Tribute to our dear Mother Livre. When the ministry started here in Wakefield on the 23rd of March 2015, Mother Livre was one of our founding members. She was added to the body of the Vision Apostolic House of Prayer. She was the loving, passionate, and considerate member of the body. She took her hands of fellowship May 30th, 2015, and a year later was ordained as church mother. We consider our dear sister a pillar of our body of Christ in our local assembly. On her passing to glory, we'll be missed here on earth. To be absent in body is to be present with the Lord. In 2018, when she was diagnosed with breast cancer, her illness drew her closer to God. Her mother's faith in Christ was not theoretical or detached. It was a living faith in a living Savior. Such dynamic faith produced tremendous works of righteousness. Her faith real work. She endured hardship with joy. Her rest was worship, prayer, singing of hymns, and reading her Bible. In our last day, Mother Livre's relationship with God was a living one. Jesus Christ was a lover of her soul, and she walked with him and talked with him, enjoying sweet communion with him daily. She was a woman of great courage, who faced every problem with confidence in a complete reliance upon ever-present Lord. Before she entered in the presence of the Lord, she encouraged those with the Lord. Before she entered into the presence of the Lord, she encouraged those with her to love Jesus and serve him faithfully all their days. On September 14, 2022, God took our mother to himself. The angels came and brought her perfect spirit to her master and Lord. Truly, our mother's death was a good death. It is very important that we pay heed to this veterinarian soldier of the cross who followed her master faithfully for the last 7 years. Let us love Jesus and serve him faithfully. Of the living gods. You have entered his gate with singing and in the last joy, crowns your head. Gladness and joy have overtaken you, and sorrow and sighing have fled away. Mother Livre, your sun will never set again. Your moon will wane no more. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of sorrow and labor have ended. You are now before the throne of God, to serve him always in his temple. He who sits on the throne has already spread his tent over you, and never again will you hunger, never again will you thirst. The Lamb is the center of the throne, will be your shepherd, and will lead you to springs of living water. God has wiped away every tear from your eyes. Now your face glows with joy, your eyes sparkle with splendor. Oh, dearest Mother, you have entered into your eternal rest. And what is that rest? What is that blessing? It is seeing the face of Jesus, who we loved for many, many years. We grieve today, we will grieve tomorrow, and we grieve all the days for you, our Mother. But we are also glad that you are eternally happy, for you will be no more death, no more mourning, no more crying, no more pain. Soon
our own sorrow and pain will also be over. It is only a matter of time, and then we will come to trust in Jesus, to join you and your Lord in God's everlasting joy and the unending celebration of heaven. Thank God we have all his faithful servant who is present below. A Lord is suffering in this ailing and sickling body any further. We do participate in your grief over the death of our dear mother, and hope that we will see her again when all saints come forward to meet you in the air. We pray for all the surviving members of the family that God may console them. On behalf of the Ministry of Additional Apostolic Council of Prayer, we render our sincere condolences to the living family. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Put your hands together for our center for such a wonderful tribute on behalf of the vision of Apostle Paul for prayer. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Alright, so we're going to have a second musical tribute from one of these daughters, Anika Lee, who is not here. And then I'm going to take one from our pastor, Pastor Thomas. And then I'm going to open the floor to those who want to give tribute. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bless the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
And family members, friends, all, let me say a present good morning to you all. It is such a great privilege that I can stand here in the house of God, knowing that I am one that knows Mother Levy, and know that she was and still a God-fearing person. And when she was part of our denomination, we could testify to say, yes, she's somebody that loved the Lord. And praise be to God, even though she did not go home there back in the world. She replaced herself with the people of God. And so I am proud to know and to say we are not here to weep and mourn because of our passing. Because when you look it all too, she is in a better place than even us here today. Amen, somebody. Hallelujah. Because, you know, no more sorrow, no more sickness, no more pain. My God, and she chose to be with the Lord. That's one better place. Because if you did not choose to be with the Lord, you must choose to be with the devil. Amen, somebody. Hallelujah. And then I can remember when we went to look for Mother Levy and to see the type of sickness that she had. And she had such pleasant reasoning. You know that it must be somebody that is keeping in touch with the Lord. Amen, somebody. And so this day, I am saying to everyone that did not even accept Jesus into their life as yet, it is now is the time. Because when we look at the time that we are living into now, my God, it's only Jesus can help us. Amen. And so I can say this evening, precious in the sight of the Lord, as the scripture said, is the death of his saints. So thank God for the life of Mother Levy. Now pray and hope that her family will take a leaf out of our book and walk in that pathway too. Because it's wonderful to be in a funeral service for a child of God. You are talking, when you are talking about somebody that being with Christ and being less to tell any lies. Amen. Amen. Because so many times we go to funeral and those people never even walk to a church door. Yet still they are saying they are so rest in peace with the Lord. Well, I am saying this evening, I am saying this moment, may our dear mother, living soul, continue to rest in the Lord.
Infatuate this morning, bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus.
Bless the Lord. Amen. Does that come on everybody? She's such a wonderful person to me. When I got saved, I didn't know that she knew that I got saved. I don't know if it was a dream of the Lord, but she called me like the day after. I was wonderful husband to me in Christ. On behalf of my counselor, Mr. Matthew Warren, and just seeing how I guess she's on her way, but I don't know if she reached her yet. We're sending condolence to her family. As a manager to her, to remind me to leave this to this good up and trust me. This morning, I'm happy for her.
Amen.
She called me like on a daily basis. We spoke together. She feels so much better. I want to say to her, say, Loretta, how you manage, how you do it, how you feel so much pain, I'm still up and running. And she never give up.
Amen.
She never give up. She always has the babies. They're not what we have got to children, as the pastor said, you can leave from her life. Being a Christian is not a burden. I got saved, and I could never ask for nothing better in my life, knowing where I am coming from. And I will continue with the Lord and study the way you're so blessed to be with it. And I know that God has enough agents.
Amen.
Sunday morning, we shall see Jesus in the air. Coming down to you and me, what joy, a joy mentioned. All our nations will be I want to sing a favorite song of Loretta. And let I tell you who I am, Bishop McLean from the Church of Christ over here in Manchester. And it's a privilege to be in St. Catherine, to be in Manchester here. When Sister Loretta died, I was on the plane to Miami. When I got the phone call, I said, I must be in Jamaica for the funeral. Shall we praise the Lord? Tonight we sing very much. And then it's better than this world. Sorry,
Thank you. again. Lord.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Rest! Rest and strong! Bless the name of Jesus! Rest and strong!
I know more than you from this church in Baker.
to you. Mother Lee come like a sister to me. I love Mother Lee today. And I am just distribute because of song. The song is to encourage Mother Lee this family. And to tell Mother Lee this family where Mother Lee is now.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Worship the Lord this morning. This is something that is a good one. Midnight cry, we'll be gone.
sound of mighty rushing wind. And it's closer now.
Possibly the entire day, because there's a lot that we can see about Mother Eve. But I just like to do the trees there. And the first is that she was a person that had no fear of death. She was so made up in her mind of where she is in Christ that she will tell you every time you talk to her, if I'm to die, no pastor, I am going that. And I'm sure that if she was here today, or if she had the opportunity to speak to you today, she would probably say, Pastor, you know what? Don't even tell him about me. Tell him that it is a privilege to be here and not around. And the second thing that I like about her, well, actually love about her, is that she had a genuine care for God's work and God's people. Come on, somebody worship God. And if nobody else ever feel like they're a teacher of motherly being, make me feel like I'm a teacher. And make me feel like my preaching room. And she went on to ask what she was asking. I mean, say they may have to be accountable to you. You know, and we had a conversation, and I can tell you that that conversation, I'm sure that nobody has ever heard of that conversation. And so, first, she was a confident for me. Worship the Lord. And the final thing that I loved about the woman of God is that she was faithful.
Yes.
So normally I would come from Portland to wait. And I can tell you that she was one of the only person that kept me going. Every time I felt like giving up, just pulling up at the gate and saw her sitting in the seat where nobody is there. I have a spoke for once about being early. And from the top word I want them, every time I come to church, rain, sun, or shine, she's here. Because she said, you know what? If pastor I come all the way from Portland, I cannot make it come and I am not here. And so she was a faithful servant of God. Faithful servant of God. And as I would like to see the church and the family know. You know, some persons are influential because they are rich.
Yes.
Some persons are influential because of the name that they carry. Like you're born in a certain family.
Yes.
Some persons are influential because of their job title. But I believe that this woman of God is influential because of who she was. Honored today to celebrate the life that she has lived. And her one dying question to me, like when I left the church, we would talk from time to time. But every time she talked, the first question she would ask me, Pastor, when are you going?
Amen.
I remember I came back once and I preached a sermon. By the time I got home, the phone rang. And the one question that we have to ask is, when are you coming back? And so in that state, I felt like I filled her in that regard. Because I believe that that was one of her greatest wish, to see me return to the sanctuary. But you know, the one thing that stood out about her above everything. And I will close by saying this, you know, Paul in his caution to Timothy was saying to him that, you got it. You know, the time will come, it will not endure so much. And she told him, he was basically saying to him, time will come when you're going to get sick.
Yeah.
And it is at that time you're going to be called to be a Christian. It's if we talk, we're talking about.
Yes.
But when you're to walk the walk, it's a total different thing. Giving thanks when we are higher than the world. But what about when pain is rocking your body? What about when it comes to that and the doctor gives you a bad news? Even when she was told that she had cancer, she told me, she said, Pastor, I'm sorry to tell her. You say, well, you know, say, well, you have to do this. So obviously, it must be something about that. She said, I'm giving God thanks anyway. The doctor said, me have cancer.
My God.
I told her, I said, oh, my God. Yeah, trust me. She said to me,
amen.
She was so mean up in her mind, Bridget. And she said, you know what, Pastor? If God wants this cancer, I have to go. It has to go.
Amen.
But if it is not His will, I'm going to still trust Him. And so I do like all the things that went on before. Even your children would like to say to everyone that is here, not just the family, do not take just a page, but take the entire book that this woman had lived. What I was going to do here, I realized that there was an underlying theme. And you know what that theme was? Is that she loved God.
Amen.
From the very get-go, she loved God.
Amen.
Whether people think it, she good or bad, she loved God.
Amen.
Whether she was rich or poor, she loved God. Whether she was sheltered or unsheltered, she loved God. And for that, I just want the church to stand with, you know, because she should let know and she can't hear.
Amen.
But today, you know, when you go to a damn funeral, I really wash up this. Come on to somebody and say, we want to stand in respect of a true woman of God and pay homage to her life and her service. Come on, I wish the church would get excited with me. Because if this place of God is here,
in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Parker. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. If you are rejoicing, how much can you can tell so much to one life? It is that she lived a life. She did make her life speak for her. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're now going to take up our offering. Bless the name of Jesus. And I'm going to ask our missionary Edward and our secretary Mary to come. Bless the name of Jesus. While that is being done, we're going to sing the song "When Israel Out of Bondage Came."
When Israel out of bondage came, I see the poor
and lame.
The Lord reached out His mighty and
thank you. Praise the Lord. Worship the name of the Lord. Worship the name of the Lord. I'll say of the Lord, He is my refuge.
Thank you.
talk to myself, this can be no Christian.
Yeah.
No God can be these people who carry themselves like this. But she realized that we were carrying something on the inside.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord. We were carrying something within. But the natural eye could not recognize. Only the Spirit of God could. Without confirmation, she became a part of us. A good moderator. A good moderator. A good worshiper. Many persons have not accomplished what they could have because the parents didn't have it. Modeling is the ability to grasp the principles when we are teaching. Sometimes you have to start up. Look at her to say. Hold it back a little bit. I know you get this already, but we want to learn from the others. Intelligent woman. When I realized that she became ill, and the illness might have ultimately led to her death, this is a part of leadership that I don't like. I don't go funerals unless I don't have a choice. When I went to see her and I visited her, and I began to pray and I said, God, I'm getting frustrated. I'm getting discouraged. I'm doing what you said. She's still there. What's the sense? I'm getting frustrated. But then I began to realize that we don't want our loved ones to leave us. Because death was never a part of God's plan. And so because we were not born to die,
yes,
because we were born to live,
yes,
when death faces us, we wrestle with it,
yes,
in spite of our faith in God.
Hallelujah.
When I saw her traveling now, and I realized this may be it, Mr. Jesus, my God.
Amen.
I don't know as a shepherd yet, or to usher one of my children home. When I was told I needed to go to the hospital, God would have it. He called me. I said, thank you, Jesus, because I'm here saying, if I'm to go and give Shanika support, me feel like I'm a job. We need somebody to support me. And then, thankfully, God had him called and he came. When I went, God gave me the strength. And he gave me some songs to sing for her. And I sang. She was a bit restless, but as I sang, she relaxed, began to take the worship song.
Hallelujah.
I whisper in her ears and I say, it is well.
Hallelujah.
It's with you.
Amen.
Don't worry.
Amen.
She began to relax.
Amen.
Because at the point of exit, the flesh wants to tell us some stuff.
Yes.
At the point of exit, the flesh wants you to question. Have I done enough?
My God.
Have I done enough? Will I need me? But my heart was at peace. And knew she was going home. And the Lord made me to celebrate now this part of leadership. He said, this, I called you to shepherd them. And not just half the way, but all the way through. So I was happy that I was a part of that last leg.
Amen.
I'm going to briefly share with you from scriptures. St. Luke chapter 16. I'm going to read a few verses from verse 19 to 31. You may remain seated. I will keep you long. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid. No, there was a certain rich man. Which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate full of sores, and desired to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried. carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torment, and seeing Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. He cried and said, Father, by Abraham, have mercy on me. But Abraham said, son, remember that you in your life receivest good things.
Yes.
Likewise, Lazarus, evil things.
Amen.
Now he's comforted.
Yes.
And you are tormented.
Amen.
Besides all this, between us and you, there's a great gulf fixed. So that they which will pass from hence to you cannot. Neither can they pass to us that would come from thence. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house. I have 5 brethren, that we may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. Abraham said unto him, they are Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, nay, Father Abraham, but if one man comes to them from the dead, they will repent. He said unto them, if they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead. Was carried into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died, and he was buried.
Yes.
My question this afternoon is, how are you going to be taken?
Will
you be carried, or will you be buried?
One day.
beautiful it looks. Apart from the fact that age will make it sun and give you satellite, you women who are honest, apart from that, there'll be a day when you're gonna chop it off. not the final say. Every time I go to look for this woman of God, even when she's stretched over her back, she's encouraging me more. I'm trying to get that to go on. Because our bishop is supposed to not give her strength, but I'm pulling strength from the day. And just as she said to others, Apostle, people are saying this and say that, me not going away. I will not go anywhere to ask somebody no question. I have been coming up with that foolishness now before.
Amen.
If this is what God is going to use to take me home, then Apostle, so be it. Come on, children of God. What greater life? What greater life? We're only passing through. Everything, look around you. The only thing that is temporary is our souls. Everything that you are able to visibly see is temporary. But the souls of man shall never die. The question though is, I'm going to be alive, but where? Where will be my place of residency? Was the Lord talking foolishness? When you talk about this place of torment, church, you really preach for you too much again. Can you ever preach in the place that are only Christians? So you know what we keep them in it. We keep the earth out short. As if it was Moses. But the devil is a liar. One thing is for certain, it doesn't matter how much we love our loved ones, not one of you are prepared to die. Very few parents are prepared to die for their own child. They will grieve for a long time, but very few are prepared to die for their own child. It therefore means that there is going to come a time where no matter how
your right family.
So who is to tell that as I'm not one God is speaking. I would have chosen somewhere else. But because we walked in obedience, she became a part of us and she found her family. As Pastor Thomas said, she started the journey there. She could have ended it out in the world. But God sent her home to her family. He knew that we would have been the one to usher her into him. And we celebrate her life. I'm telling you, children of God, when I grow up with her, she doesn't need the Bible or the e-book. The word of God hidden in my heart that I may not sin against you. She has the word of God hidden within. When you look at her now lying there, she looks like a bride. She looks like a bride. And that's who she is. Because her bridegroom came. He came. And she went with him. All I would encourage you to do, even after the end of this celebratory service, think about the word that you heard. Give some thought to it. Do you want to be carried? Or do you want to be buried? God bless you, Jesus. This is an addition. It's going to come to the lineage. Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Good afternoon. Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's such a joy and a sadness to be here this afternoon. Bless the name of Jesus. Mother Libby was like a aunt to me. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Because mommy was one of her best friends. I don't know if she had others, but she was her friend. Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. From growing up, she would normally come from home to Comer here, Washington, Comet, and she'd spend the day. Those were the days. Bless the Lord. Personal eulogy of Pamela Levy, born on January 20th, 1960.
Yes, the Lord. Amen.
Died on September 14, 2022. Am I a soldier of the cross, a follower of the Lord? And shall I fear to win this cause or push to speak his name? Must I be carried to the skies? On flowery beds of peace, while others fought to win the prize, and sailed the tongues. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But this is a part I like. Since I must fight, if I should reign, increase my courage, Lord. She has bared the toil. She has endured the pain, supported by his word. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Pamela Monroe, otherwise known as Loretta, was born on January 20th, 1960, in the district of Wakefield, to parents Ezekiel Monroe and Cynthia Dennis, the second child of her parents. She started her former schooling at the Buxton College at the age of 7 years. At the age of 15, her time was up.
She later was sent to the Rosemont to continue, and she spent approximately 2 years at this institution, and she completed her time. She was at home with her mother, doing and learning home chores. While there, her neighbor, Mr. Stephen McIntosh, had eyes on the fluffy young lady. As a man all over, he presented his argument and request to her for friendship, but it wasn't immediate yes. He kept on knocking at the door until she finally agreed to be his friend. After being in friendship for a time, she realized that she was pregnant with her first child. She was happy because she would be a proud mother. This happiness was short-lived because Mr. McIntosh left the community and she was all alone. When her time came, she delivered a she sought employment at Stanley's property, Buxton Town, as a day laborer. This wasn't the type of life she wanted for herself. And after a year at Stanley's, she packed her belongings and headed to Porus in Manchester at her mother's house. Loretta was a person that always loved church. And living in Manchester, she found a place of worship. One day while going down the road with her sister Monica, a young man called Monica. They talked for a while because they knew each other. This young man inquired who the young lady was. He was told that she was Monica's sister, Loretta. The young man, Herbert Levy, or otherwise known as Roy, indicated that he liked her. Mr. Levy, Roy, opened or established a business in the poorest community as a technician, doing quite well. Loretta and Roy began a friendship, but not leaving out her church, attendance of which Roy had no problem with. Loretta and her mother had a misunderstanding, of which she left her house. Roy took her to his house, where they became and had a relationship. After a while, Mr. Levy decided to return to his community of Inimibate in Clarendon. Loretta, along with her daughter Stacy Ann, accompanied him. At this time, she was pregnant with Mr. Levy's first child, Christopher Levy. Roy continued working while Loretta stayed home, taking care of the children at home, but she always wanted to attend church. On seeing her intentions and love for God, some of the church members, along with the pastor, came and spoke to Roy about their relationship and encouraged them to be married and become members. This to their ears. And so, on August 8, 1983, they were married in Maiden, Clarendon. Months after they were married, home beckons Loretta. She returned to Wakefield with her family. Mr. Levy needed work to sustain his family, so he sought employment at Stanley's property, Boston, as a day laborer. The wages wasn't to his satisfaction, so he decided to return to Clarendon. He had a friend by the name of Donovan, who asked him to stay and introduce the burning of coal to him. Roy started this new line of work, which was more profitable than the property's work. After a while, another baby was added to the family, a sweet little girl whom they named D'Amico Levy, otherwise known as Kay. Mr. Levy's friend Donovan sought to help him improve his life, so they were both hired at Content Week Center in Cornwall. This was a much better paying job, and it allows them to get tour and a travel to many different places in Jamaica. He worked for approximately 8 years, and during that time, two other children were added to the family, Shanika, also known as Shanshan, and Romario, also known as Clay, Bibi. Loretta loved the Lord, and so she became a member of the Full Gospel Deliverance Church of God, Banegoli. She was a viral member, and after a while, her husband became a member. After serving for some time, they both left. Loretta loved the Lord and the place where his name is called. She was always involved with church, and not wanting to be idle, she placed her membership at the Mount Carmel AME Zion Church. Whenever she stands to give her testimony, she always says, "God is so good to me, I can't complain." And she put on an accent to teach corporate anger. "God is so good to me, I can't complain." Honestly, she would. After being there for years, she left. For quite some time, she visited Bishop Apostolic Church and found the worship and fellowship very inspiring. So she made this her church home. This became a reality when on May 30th, 2015, she was officially made a member until the time of her death. In 2006, she fell ill and was sent by the doctor to do some tests, of which the results wasn't what she liked. She was diagnosed with cancer in 2015. She had surgery to remove one of her breasts. She received the necessary treatment, and after a while, in 2017, she was ill again. This time, it was a blood circulation problem. This resulted in a minor surgery on one of her feet. She was treated and her foot healed. In 2021, she went to the hospital. She was rushed to the hospital where she received immediate medical attention. In January 2022, she had a breathing problem and was once again hospitalized. But she miraculously pulled through. She was given a letter to use and instructed to take. She was leaving behind her husband, Herbert Levy, Roy, sons, Christopher Levy, Romario Levy, daughters, Stacey and Levy, Demico Levy, and Shanika Levy. Five grandchildren, five sisters, and two brothers in law. Her beloved church family, nieces, nephews, other relatives, and friends. May her soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine on you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can you stand us for a minute? Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. This plane I'm riding, this plane I'm sleeping, for a place where we shall never die.
Thank you.
Conviction.
John. Mighty God, knowing the evening that soon this part is going to be carried, is going to be buried, and not carried, mighty God, bring conviction, hallelujah, bring conviction, hallelujah, hallelujah. May this message dwell in them and bring them to the foot of the cross. Come on, demand your blood. Keep them in the bond of peace, love, and unity. Do for them more than we can do. God, I pray that you bless the preacher. God, as the word goes forth, may everyone, Father God, take this word serious. Oh, God, and to see what we are working for, whether to be carried on to be buried. God, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. We are about to go to the burial ground. I ask for your covering, your guidance, your direction, and your presence. Bless, sanctify, heal, deliver, and set free. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
We just ask him for years to come. I'm not sure where the location is, but we're going to follow. I'm told that we have to drive, it's not walking distance. So when we sing the recessional hymn, asking for the followers to just assist us get to the casket. Are you a prophet? I am a friend.
Before that's where I'll be. Red Charm on go. Thank you. Don't you ever think I'll see you? It's a glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the prophecy forever, just beyond the shining river, when the ring goes golden bells,
don't you hear?
Don't you hear? Don't you hear? It's a glory. Hallelujah. You believe in the prophecy forever, just beyond the shining river. When the ring goes golden bells,
we hear from strong men.
Hallelujah.
We need some help to get the gospel all the way.
Hola.
Yes, said the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors like their work.
We're going to sing another song, even as the workmen prepare. No grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. I'm the rest of love. You can hold my body down.
I'm gonna leave this world. I stand along with you. if you move, brother. If you move, if you move, brother. If you move, brother. If you
go back where I of my life.
I'm in the shadow. I'm in the Oh.
blood of the eternal Christ. You will still work in you that was created in the meantime. Jesus Christ, our Lord, may God bring your reverence to heaven. May the grace of our Lord be with us.
I'm gonna do something with my kid, boy. My pretty boy.
Why are you coming?
Oh, Andrea, see you, Michael.
What are you doing?
Drive, see you, Michael. We drive, come on.